Every organization is an extended shadow of an individual. So be it Kalakshetra, and it is a virtual version, which I can say, for Rukmini Devi Arundel. And today the book is all about Rukmini Devi, a life lesson by Leela Samson. Leela Samson is a renowned Bharatanatyam dancer, and she has totally wrote about Rukmini Devi Arundel, her total biography, how she has created and she has made Kalakshetra, and all her endeavors on that. The theme of this book is all about, not only about Bharatanatyam, it is about the great cultural change which Rukmini Devi have brought in India. In fact, with respect to Bharatanatyam, let it be Women's Divorce Act, that is Women's Wellness Side Divorce Act, then Animal Welfare Act, and also for the Montessori education and so on. So it's a collection of everything which she has done, and not only about Bharatanatyam. I would say that it's a very good read, which I would say. In fact, I was indulged into this book for a month's time, I would say, and the rating I would give 4 out of 5, because it's such an engulfing book, and I was thinking how such a person in those kind of period was very much modern thinker. She's a modern thinker in sari, and I have to say she has broken all the myths even today with respect to the so-called modern woman what we are. So in this, let me get into her early life. Her early life, if I want to share, she has born in a Brahmin family with sisters and brother siblings in Madurai, which is in the deep south of India. What she has done is that she was able to study till 12th standard, that is higher grades, and after that she was not able to go to school because of her father's change of work which he was going through. Her brother was in Theosophical Society, but luckily she has not gone through this child marriage, which was very very easily, which can happen in India, and her elder sisters also have gone this child marriage abuse which has happened at that time. So these are her early life, and she also had the innate talent of music, which she was, as she had her uncle who is from the music background. These are about her early life. Coming back to her marriage and Theosophical Society. In Theosophical Society, that was the time when Annie Besant has made Theosophical Society to be flourished in Chennai, and there are a lot of things which was happening from the education side also from that particular society. After hearing Annie Besant's talk on that front, she was very much inspired of Annie Besant, and she started to contribute for Theosophical Society, as her brother was also very much active in Theosophical. And later, that was also the way she saw George Arundel, who is a foreigner, that is from England, and who also actively worked for Theosophical Society, and they both fall in love and they got married. Their marriage actually created a great spur at that time in India. It has gone in newspapers and everywhere, because she was a minor and marrying a person who has 26 years old difference, that to a foreigner and a Brahmin she is. In fact, she really replied and made her free-spirited choice in those period of time, which is really a hard thing or eye-winking moment for me as well to think about it. So, what happened after her marriage is that she has contributed a lot for Theosophical Society. Rukmini and George Arundel, they traveled across the world and contributed for a lot of talk which on education and funding. And in fact, at that time, she also got interest in ballet, and she has learned as a hobby little of ballet dancing which she was doing. And now comes the main crux, which I would say, that is Bharatanatyam and Kalakshetra. Before speaking about Rukmini Devi's contribution to Bharatanatyam, I wanted to say a little bit about Bharatanatyam itself. So Bharatanatyam generally, it's a classical dance form which is truly amazed and being done in southern India with great spirit, I can say. But at that time, Bharatanatyam was done by Devadasis. They are called as Devadasis or temple dancers, who generally dance in temple and they are dedicated their life for God and Goddess. And it's like an occupation, as like we all do. They are paid very less for that. And occasionally they will dance in King's Court just because it can avoid the evil over there. These are the things which was happening around Bharatanatyam, which actually made people not to have great interest other than Devadasis to get into that dance form. But Rukmini When she saw the first Pandanallu sister's performance, she really got inspired of the dance form and she wanted to start with Bharatanatyam. So that's when she started to seek gurus, but for her chance, she didn't able to get gurus at that time. Then slowly she was able to get one of the gurus and she started with her core. That's because Bharatanatyam, she wanted to then started the change with respect to Bharatanatyam, which I would say that is the Kalakshetra form, which today we adopt as one of the form in Bharatanatyam, is being the structured work by Rukmini Devi Arundel. So great hats off for her. What she has done in Bharatanatyam is that she made a massive change. Let it be from the recitals, she has changed. Wherever it is a king worship, it has been changed with God's worship. And next one, let it be from the clothes, attire, from stage decoration, music recitals and the expressions. It's all made or restructured in such a way that people can enjoy with spirituality and without any vulgarity. So for her, the theme is education without fear and art without vulgarity is something, the basic principle of her life, which actually we can see throughout Kalakshetras in its form even today. And in fact, that is the reason why Bharatanatyam has been appreciated today and it has been adopted by everyone in southern India, as also even in foreign countries also today I can see over there. Hats off to Rukmini Devi for bringing that great zeal of difference which she brought. Even after George Arundel had passed away, she was dancing. So she has taken that as a great principle to form this Kalakshetra with lot of people together. Though she found a lot of turbulence in Theosophical Society, she was sent out of it and then the Kalakshetra formed in Adyar. So this is the story of Kalakshetra. For knowing more, you can read about this particular book. And next comes her contribution with respect to India, that too. She had been selected by Dr. Jawaharlal Nehru, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, as one of the Rajya Sabha member. She then brought lot of bills for women empowerment. When I say there is a divorce bill which has been used now, that is also by her. And also let it be from Animals Welfare Association side, she has passed many of the bills. So that they can be stopped from sending for experimentation and so on. So overall, her massive work with respect to Indian culture and change is something immense. I would say every individual to read this book, because it is one such must read book of this era. Because after reading this book, only thing, such a person who had made great change for the Indian culture in a span of 80 plus years. So, if you like our video, please subscribe to our channel and please hit the like button. We'll come back with one more book review soon. One thing which I want to share from my personal story is that when I was a small kid, I was joining Bharatanatyam class. But as because the teacher is very strict, I gave up. And the point is, I lost almost 26 plus years without doing Bharatanatyam. Right. So if I would have done at early age, right now I would have done most of the senior stuff in that actually. But no ways, I have started, learnt later and I have started recently my Bharatanatyam. So one message is that any teacher, if you are more compassionate with the students and if you can teach them in a way where enjoyable, any subject, maybe Bharatanatyam or Max, it is going to be fun for them. So that is the take from this book. Thank you.